Hey, it's Victoria McCooey. I want to talk to you about the five stages of grief. So you've probably heard about them. They're very commonly known as the stages of grief you go through when you're mourning a death or loss, right? So what I want to talk about, though, is how they show up in divorce. Because whether you realize it or not, divorce is a death. Even if you're the one who wants out of the marriage, you still have to mourn the death of that marriage. You have to mourn it like any other death. It's the death of a dream you had. You didn't think you would be divorced. You married this person thinking you were going to grow old together, thinking you would be buried side by side, thinking that you would have grandchildren together and share this whole lifetime together. And that dream is gone now. So you have to mourn the death of that dream. So the five stages of grief look like this. The first is denial. So this is how this shows up in divorce, in denying that it's happening, denying that your marriage has come to an end, denying that you have to end your marriage, that you have to get out of this situation. The next stage is anger. So now you're angry. You're angry that this had to happen to you. It's not what you wanted. It's not what you set out for. This is not the way you planned your life to go, the way you thought it would go. You didn't expect to have a failed marriage. This was not your plan. So you're angry, right? You're mad at the world. You're mad at God. You're mad at the universe. You're mad at yourself. You're mad at your spouse. You're angry. So then the next stage is bargaining, where you make deals. You make deals with your spouse. You make deals with God. You make deals with yourself. If only this would happen, then I would whatever. Fill in the blank. So this bargaining thing that you start doing to try to make things right again. Then the fourth stage is depression. It's hitting you. There's no way out. This is happening, and you just don't know how you're going to reinvent yourself, how you're going to get through it, how you're going to see your life so differently now. And it's just too much to handle, and you get depressed. You don't want to get out of bed. You want to pull the covers up and just retreat. You're tired. You lose your appetite. You're just in a fetal position all day long, right? So that if you could, if that would be your choice, if you could just stay in bed all day, that would be your choice. The fifth stage is acceptance. Hallelujah, right? You finally get to the point where you accept it. You understand that it's necessary and that you see yourself moving through it. You can see what's going to be on the other side, and you're hopeful. All right, so here's the question I get asked all the time. Do they always come in this order? And once I'm over one, is that it? No, it's not linear. You bounce back and forth. Some people skip whole stages. No two people are alike. You might stay in one stage way longer than somebody else. You might skip another stage altogether. Everyone's different. But so why do we even bother, right? Why do we even bother talking about this? Because when you know what to expect, you can recognize it. So like if you didn't understand this process and you suddenly were depressed and in bed and you couldn't get out, you might think, I'll never be the same. I'm never going to be normal again. Just going to be depressed the rest of my life. No, it's a stage, and you will move through it. So you see the patterns. You start recognizing, oh, I'm bargaining. This is the bargaining stage. And you understand that this is what everyone does. You're not alone. This is how we all process this grief that we're feeling over the loss of our marriage, the death of our marriage. So when you can understand it and anticipate, you'll start when you start moving out of one stage and you get like say you're in anger and you start doing this bargaining, you're like, oh, I'm progressing. because I was angry last week. This week, I'm starting to bargain. Maybe next week, I'll get depressed. You know, you understand that you're moving through and you are progressing, and that is this is not the rest of your life. This is not how you're going to feel forever. There are stages, and you will process through them, and then you'll go on, and you can reinvent yourself. You can create a whole new life where you'll be completely happy, and it's all up to you what you do after that. So I hope this helps you understand how you get through these stages. So I've created a whole outline of this for you, and with specific examples of what each of these stages look like in divorce. And if you would like to have that, I will put in the notes the link where you can register, and I'll send it right to you. And I'm also going to send you as a bonus a checklist. So not only will you learn all about these stages and what they mean or look like in divorce, but I'll give you a checklist so you can actually check off what you've been through, what you're feeling, how it applies to you, and you can see the progress you're making, even though it doesn't feel like progress. It's like one is just as bad or worse than the one before, right? But it is progress because you're getting through all the stages. So I hope that helps. And if you want to talk to me about your own situation, you can always book a free call with me right on my website, victoriamakui.com/calendar. All right. I hope to talk to you soon.